Welcome to Doggo.jl, your home for wholesome Julia tutorials. This episode is the first chapter in a collection of short how-to videos to help you get started on your journey to learning how to write code using the Julia programming language. No programming knowledge is required, so I'm assuming that Julia is your first programming language. To get the most out of these videos, you will need access to a computer with an internet connection. And by computer, I mean either a desktop or a laptop computer running Windows, macOS, or Linux. Everything else in the course will be free. As a human, you cannot communicate directly with your computer by using your spoken language. In order for you to talk to your computer, you will need to use a programming language. You may think that a programming language is only used by software developers. But there are many different reasons why you may want to use a programming language. Here's a diagram of some humans that may benefit from the use of a computer programming language. At the top of the diagram is the human brain. And at the bottom of the diagram is the computer brain. There is no single programming language that can meet the needs of all of these diverse users. As a result, there are many different programming languages that are currently being used, each with their own unique capabilities. Where you choose to spend your time will determine which programming language is best for you in order for you to accomplish your goals. The Julia programming language is a good choice for users in the higher tiers. And by higher, I don't mean better. By higher, I mean that users in those tiers need a programming language that works in a way that is closer to the way that a human brain works, as opposed to a programming language in the lower tiers that works in a way that is closer to the way that a computer brain works. The Julia programming language is a relatively new language, and it's the highest level programming language ever created. Folks all over the world are using Julia to work on some very clever projects. Julia is currently being used for space exploration and robotics, life sciences research, climate modeling, finance and economics, data science, machine learning, supercomputing, quantum computing, and more. If your aspiration is to become a theoretical and/or academic scientist to work on cutting-edge research in math and/or science, then Julia may be a good choice for you. On the other hand, if your aspiration is to become a professional software developer to work in industry to create commercial products and/or services, then Julia may not be a good choice for you, at least not as a first language. If you find yourself in one of these lower tiers, you may be interested in my second channel, Doggo.rs, which is dedicated to the Rust programming language. On that channel, I'm uploading a collection of short how-to videos to help you get started on your journey to learning how to write code using Rust. But whatever you decide to do, don't try to learn two languages at the same time, since it will get confusing. If you don't know what you want to do, but would still like to learn a programming language, just flip a coin and pick one language, and stick with it until you're comfortable using it. The reality is, no matter which path you decide to take, you'll eventually need to learn more than one language. And most programming languages are similar in concept, so once you're comfortable with one programming language, then the second programming language will be easier to learn. As for me, I am not a professional software developer, nor do I possess a computer science degree. I am not an expert in any particular programming language. I am a self-taught coding hobbyist who enjoys learning new things and enjoys making videos here on YouTube. Julia is my first programming language, and I've been using it for about 3 years. I started this YouTube channel 3 years ago as a side project to help me learn Julia, and as a way to help others who are interested in learning Julia with me. Even though it's only been 3 years, my Julia for Beginners playlist is already out of date, so I'm launching this new series of videos in order to refresh my old content. This will provide some time for my regular viewers to catch up on some of my other videos, and it will give new students an opportunity to get started using the latest tools. By the end of this series, you won't be a Julia expert, but you'll have a very good idea if programming is right for you. And if you decide that you're interested in programming, then you'll also have a very good idea if Julia is right for you. Even if you conclude that programming and/or Julia is not right for you, that's okay too. That means that you learn something about yourself. And in the end, self-discovery is really what education is all about. The hardest part of any educational journey is having the courage to take that first step. You're at the trailhead now, so it's not too late to turn back. But if you're ready to move forward, then let's get started. In the next chapter, you'll learn how to install Julia onto your computer.